All right, you open it up.
Why do you sound so discouraged, John? I know why.
Because I've had to do this 3 fucking times.
Yeah, we're not good at this yet, but we will be soon.
Oh, we are not.
Welcome to Bomb Burrito Gaming. I'm John.
No, you need to start with a little more energy.
Well, I thought we did start by making fun of you.
No, that wasn't going to be.
Okay. I don't want to start with more energy. You're not the boss of me.
Hello, and welcome back to Bomb Burrito Gaming. I am JC, and I'm here with my best friend and lover, John.
That is me.
And
and what are we doing today?
And we are going to sit in that uncomfortable silence for the rest of the episode. All right, we are playing more Mario Maker today, and I have the first level already picked out, Mario Slam Basket Bomb. And I did us the courtesy of picking levels out ahead of time, so I wouldn't just be fumbling around with awful levels like last time.
And I mean, that was a good level, but yeah, we did fumble around with it quite a bit.
Yeah, well, I mean, remember the one that we tried for like 30 seconds that you tried, and then we couldn't do it because it was stupid?
Which one was that?
The one we had to wall jump, like don't touch the skeleton.
Oh, I do recall that. Yeah, I did not. Was not a fan.
No.
So this one is called, what is this called again?
Mario Slam Basketball.
Mario Slam Basketball.
Yes, yes. Space Jam.
Space Jam.
Come on and slam. This is the third time we've had to try starting this because we've had a series of technical difficulties. So I feel awkward about reusing jokes. But I guess it would be new for you guys.
I think we've run out of jokes. I don't think there are any other jokes.
Yeah. We made all the jokes that we have in the first 5 episodes and they weren't even any good. Oh, God.
See? Now we'll just...
Anyway, so...
Is there a stereotype about Italians playing basketball? See, we're so out of jokes that we have to go to racist school.
I can't think of a single Italian. Oh, my God. I can't think of a single Italian that plays basketball.
Interesting.
The Italian basketball team is all just like... Probably, I don't know. It's LeBron James in a mustache. So I've been quite ill for the last 36 hours or so.
I still want to recycle these jokes that I made about... You told them they were ill in the fake episode too.
Yeah, well...
Let's skip to the stuff that you said. You said there's some things you wanted to talk about in this episode, and you weren't sure if you wanted to talk about them, but we're out of stuff.
You don't even know what it is.
I know the first one.
Okay. Well, let's talk about the joke that we were just talking about.
Which one is that?
About how Star Wars, the new Star Wars, got spoiled for me.
Okay, that's good. So start from the beginning.
I feel really awkward talking about this.
No, but start from the beginning.
What's the beginning?
The beginning is you find pornographic comments very funny.
Oh yeah, like if you're a user of like Pornhub or a porn site that has comments, always check the comments when you're done because it's usually generally like very creepy like things like, oh, I'd love to do that to you or something like that.
And I like how you specified when you're done. You see that shit right before.
Not
you?
Beforehand. No, absolutely not.
Yeah.
But yes, they're always really funny, so I always check them out. But about December of last year, about the time the Star Wars movie came out, I wasn't able to see it opening weekend, and spoiler alert, oh my god. If you haven't seen it, then, I don't know, skip ahead 20 seconds or so. But I'm scrolling through the comments, and just no context, there's a guy who just goes, I can't believe Han Solo died, but at least they found Luke Skywalker. And I just go, no! And it's like, it's the funniest thing in the world to me, but I can't tell anybody without first being like, yeah, so I was jerking off the other day.
Well, I want to know details. Did you check afterwards?
What do you mean did I check afterwards?
So did you check after your activities?
Probably, I don't know.
Oh, you're just there like, I wonder what's going on Pornhub.
You know, yeah, sometimes I just check the comments. Like, I'm not even there to watch porn.
You need to pick me up.
Yeah.
You want to study misogyny.
There are some people who are doing much worse than I am in the comment section of Pornhub, and it makes me feel pretty good about myself. Oh my god, I'm almost out of time.
What are there... Oh, dang.
I'm really struggling with this.
Are there any interesting usernames on Pornhub, or are they like...
Probably not.
There's like a bunch of letters. So their mom can't...
I think the name of the guy who spoiled Star Wars for me was called like No Pants Dance or something like that.
Real original.
Oh god, I'm struggling, man.
Is there a LeBron joke we can make here about him struggling?
Oh,
because he won, didn't he?
Yeah, he did win. Oh my god. But that actually wasn't the thing that I wanted to talk about today. The thing I want to talk about, or I feel like I should talk about, just to as a
as
a warning to everyone else. So I accidentally paid $40 for pornography this week. Oh my god! Oh my god! Okay.
That's really funny.
So
this is my first time hearing this.
Yeah. So I was on Pornhub, as you are, and they have like these ads on the side that are just like, "Hey, check out the site. Free trial for like a dollar." And I'm like, "I've got a dollar." So I check it out, and it's like, "Yeah, free 3-day trial to this website for a buck." Oh my god, I'm gonna lose this level.
This is bullshit.
So,
it's okay.
So I do it, and I'm like, yeah, okay. So I watched the video I was there for, and so, but eventually I get to thinking, like, what if they just re-up me for the subscription if I don't cancel? So a couple days later, damn it, I check my email, and they're like, yeah, we're gonna, you get resubscribed for a full month membership if you don't opt out within the time limit. And I was an hour too late.
Oh, so man. How did you not know that was coming, man?
I should have, because every subscription service in the world does that. Like, Apple Music, I'm looking at you. But at least you're a little less degrading to have for a month. So I end up going on this, like, help chat woman for, like, the site.
And that's funny, man.
I was so embarrassing, like, to have to argue with somebody about, like, I don't want all this porn. Give me back my $40, please. Yeah, that was the worst thing. It was $40. Who the fuck would pay $40 for this?
One time, my neighbor accused me of buying porn. Like, I was like, I have to go make a responsible purchase. And that's because I was going to buy pizza, but it's still, that's not the point. She was like, so you're going to buy porn? And I'm like, no, porn's free, man.
Right.
And so then, like, right there, I admitted to her that I've engaged in that activity.
Well, like, for the longest time, I took pride in never having to buy it, so, like, or never actually doing it.
So, $1.
Yeah, but, so, I knew I was going back in my own personal morals when I decided to pay $1 for it. Is that necessary?
Yeah, is it unnecessary? I can't see.
So, yeah, I did it to myself, and the thing is, I've still got it for another 2 weeks, and I'm gonna use the hell out of it, man. Like, let's be honest. But it's really not better than free. So
really,
really.
Why so? So how's it different?
I don't know.
For our viewers who are curious, it's just not for me.
It's not as clean of a website as like the free ones. Some of the good free ones.
Clean as in?
Like just a functioning website. Oh my god, I don't think I'm. This is a 20%
clean. The appeal that I've always heard, like that they advertise a lot, is that it's HD.
And that is true. It is.
That's nice.
It is shot well. But like, I don't know. It's just hard to find. This is going on for way too long.
It's fine. It doesn't matter.
Oh, and the fact that I can't hit this jump shot, man. God, I'm like Steph Curry in game 7.
Is this the same one as the last game?
Yeah.
So,
the same. This is the one I died on before. I don't know what to
do. Try to throw it like closer, when you're closer.
That was the opposite of what you said to do.
It's because you're an anarchist.
Zen. 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 Zen.
There you go.
There it is! Come on and slam, and welcome to the jam. Everybody get up, it's time to slam
that. I accidentally paid. That's a good line right there. I accidentally paid $40 for pornography this week.
Yeah. I felt like I needed to tell somebody that. It was not fun.
It feels good off your chest?
It does. It's liberating. It's like a confessional. Oh, God. What? Oh, God.
Smart asses. Okay. Well, then you could just... You don't need to...
I don't have a ton of time, though.
I don't think you have to dick around with this platform.
Yeah, you're right. Man. Okay. That's true.
It's a good thing. Good problem to have.
It's a good thing.
Yay!
Why was that one so much easier? It shouldn't have been. It really reminds me of, like, a basketball game with the lights.
I'm curious how they added that in.
It's just an effect. Yay!
Woo!
Game one in the books. LBJ, where are you at?
I thought you met Lyndon B. Johnson.
Lyndon B. Johnson. Hey, LBJ, how many kids you kill today?
Damn.
That was like a chant for Vietnam. For all you kids out there.
Really?
Yeah. That's like what people would be outside the White House being like... protesting Vietnam.
Oh, those hippies.
Those hippies.
That's something I want to rant about, but I don't. I'm not as you like, rant well-spoken.
About Vietnam or hippies?
LSD.
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 Okay.
So, well, not necessarily LSD, but like, I watched like an hour-long documentary on drugs, so I'm basically an expert on them now.
Okay. Tell me.
I'm super educated.
I'm not well-versed in the drugs.
Basically, the whole vibe that they were pushing forth was that drugs are illegal because of, I don't remember if it was Reagan or Nixon. It was either Reagan or Nixon. They invented the war on drugs in order to benefit their campaign.
Right.
So they knew that the public would be very anti-drugs, so they used it as like a platform. Like they knew this president, I don't know which one it was, they knew that like marijuana wasn't actually bad for you, but they knew that they would be able to stir up like hubbub. They knew that they would be able to get a passionate following against drugs. So they're like, oh, it's the war on drugs.
Yeah, it's definitely some BS, man. I mean, I personally don't really partake in anything, but like for the most part, I feel like you should be allowed to.
I agree. And also it's like, I don't like the idea of government like saving people from themselves. Like the best example is tobacco. Like why is tobacco legal when marijuana is not? No one's ever died from marijuana, but so many people die from tobacco.
Well, that's a very political thing, but right. I mean, but the idea of like not wanting to save people from themselves, I mean, there's lots of instances of that I like support, like vaccinations. I feel like everyone hates that you have to wear a seatbelt. Like it's against the law not to be wearing a seatbelt, but I feel like it makes society better that we're not just constantly dying all the time.
I think the law doesn't push it forward. So the whole making seatbelts a law doesn't make people more likely to use the seatbelt. It just the cultural push makes people more likely to push their seatbelt. Like I think the anti-tobacco ads are more effective in making people anti-tobacco as the laws. Like, people feel social pressure. Peer pressure causes me to put on my seatbelt. Actually, the thing that causes me to put on my seatbelt is that goddamn beeping noise.
That is true.
It's a fucking nightmare.
It's like the Zelda, like, one heart left type of thing. Like, oh, this needs to stop. I'll do anything.
Please, yes, I know I'm about to die.
I get the idea. Okay.
But I don't know. Oh, God. Yeah, I'm not a partaker in the drugs.
Of
course
not.
That's mostly because they're illegal.
I'm too busy watching porn all the time.
Yeah. Which is legal, by the way.
That is true.
Are we still on the same episode? Do we need to move on?
Let's a few more minutes.
Okay.
Let's push this forward. Everyone was very patient with me talking about my embarrassing pornographic stories. I can at least get them through one more level.
We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. Oh, I didn't even see what the clear rate on this one was. I never do that, but it's always so important to me.
It does kind of feel like you're in limbo when you don't know how difficult this level
is. Yeah. Okay.
I feel like you're doing pretty well.
Yeah, it's not too bad. Not too bad. We're having fun.
We're having fun. Good times.
Up, up.
Up, up, up. Up, up.
Probably the worst technique I am at this game is using enemies to jump. Goomba. That's probably nothing I need. Come on, come on.
What's that phrase they say? Something, something's last words?
Famous last words? I don't know.
Famous last words, yeah.
Oh!
I think they had anti-dart stuff on the other side.
Alright. We'll see you next time on Bomb Burrito Gaming. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. Later.
Bye.